Another episode of Let's Talk, published on the 9th of December 2019. Early access to the supporters. Subtitles are available. Timestamps are also available. In this episode, I will go through imbalanced operators, too good or too bad, on attack. One notice before the start, we'll have three categories of slightly balanced, imbalanced, and heavily imbalanced. Imbalanced doesn't mean only overpowered, it also can mean underpowered. Balanced operators, operators that I won't be talking in this video, Sledge, Ash, Termite, Twitch, IQ, Buck, Hibana, Ying, Finca, Grilock, and Kali. That is 11 operators out of 26. So let's start. Slightly balanced. Thatcher. Glass. Blitz. Blackbeard. Zofia. And Nock. Imbalanced. Fuse. Jackal. Nomad. Amaru. Maverick. Heavily imbalanced. Montaigne. Capitou. Dokebi. And Lion. Let's talk about the reasons. Slightly unbalanced Thatcher. He's in the category of slightly overpowered in the information meta, where everything is about the information from Legion Goo Mines, Maestro Evil Eyes, Mutor, Modis, Pests, disabling Yokai drones and enabling your planter to plant, even against Boost Cardiac Sensor, from destroying Kai Chargers, and much more. Thatcher, as you can see, does all of these by just throwing an EMP over or near where you want to breach. Maybe not allowing him to destroy the gadget, but temporarily disable them, as he does now to Volky cameras or the Yokai drones, would be a good thing. I'm also not a fan of just throwing EMP to get rid of everything. Something more should be done to get rid of the gadget. I will rework Thatcher as a whole. Glaz. And yeah, Glaz is annoying, but especially now, where there is Vamai and Jaeger, deployable shields and bulletproof cameras. Glaz is not as much of a broken operator as he was. I still think that Glaz can be very good in a poker strat. However, I think he's currently a bit underpowered. I do not want to see him buffed as long as he can see through the smokes. But he does need some changes. For starters, you could add a small red laser sight, as there was a long time ago, when he activated his vision to see his laser through smokes and buff his damage on rifle. That means defenders can see laser, but he will deal way more damage per shot. I will play around his gadget a bit more, but the thing is, in a CQB game, operator with snipers are simply not working. Blitz, and I feel he's a bit underpowered. I know, again, we have a situation that Blitz is an annoying operator. Therefore, I would rather like to see him deleted from the game rather than buffing him, but that's not the point of the video. However, I will change how all shields are played. You cannot hip fire, but you can hide your hand behind your shield. That means it will be a bit harder to kill you, but you won't be able to pray to the RNG god with hip fire. Then I will remove Blitz ability to sprint and would add that if someone turns away from his flash, or the flash is not directed to him, that they are not flashed. However, I will possibly make Blitz a first 2-speed 3-armor operator. Blackbeard, and I feel that he is slightly overpowered. You can argue with me all day long, and I cannot deny that, where one shot can mean death, and he can survive a few headshots, that he's really strong. But in the current meta, is it worth to sacrifice an information operator or an operator that actually brings something on the table than quote unquote just surviving 3 to more headshots? Blackbeard should be completely removed. There is no place in this game for someone to deny a fundamental thing about the game, which are headshots, and there is no way to balance that out. Zofia. She brings a lot of stuff on the table. She can be a budget Ash, a 2-speed Ash, but she also brings loads of and loads of utility. She can act as a vertical distraction due to her bridging charges and 2 impacts, as well as waste 2 ADSs, and or spot anyone that is nearby with her concussion mines. On top of the cake, she has a hollow pistol and can self-revive. She definitely needs less utility. Make that her concussion mines are not activated in the range of a defender. Do not let her to self-revive. There is no point of having that in the game. I will somehow remove her bridging charges. But for what? Flashes? I'm not sure. Nock. Nock feels slightly underpowered. Yes, she has an FMG, and no, that's not a bad gun overall. When comparing that gun to a tracker's gun, it is bad. However, FMG is a solid gun in defense. Nog brings something other on the table, the ability to silently run, and not to silently crouch as many people play with her. Running silently with the FMG can be very deadly, so she's not as bad as people tend to say. However, I feel that she's a bit lackluster. Maybe adding a visual information that you're invisible on someone's camera, like having white bar when there is someone watching Volky camera that is supposed to see you. I will not give her better guns. We don't need another F2 or R4C on a potential very powerful ability. Imbalanced. Fuse. He definitely is underpowered in the current meta. He is not bad, just replaceable by other operators. Do you want to get rid of the utility? Bring IQ or Thatcher. Do you want to do the vertical pressure? Bug Sledge or Zofia. Is AK-12 a bay? Say hello to F2. He's also too exposed on placing the charges. More often than not, in the higher games, you will get C4 when placing a fuse charge. And before you place it, you need to clear the building or the floor from the roamers. There are two things I will change. First of all, that is, you can put multiple charges in a row and activate them either on the same time, 1x1, 2x1, or 1x2. That still doesn't change the fact that he's C4 able, so you need either make him available to throw fuse charges and to stick that on the floor or on the ceiling or whatnot, or speed up the process of putting them onto the floor or onto the ceiling for at least 50% when placing them. Well, speaking of fusing the walls, make him able to fuse the ceilings, and then these cluster charges fly a bit further rather than sticking in the radius of 5 meters. Not all of these changes can be made, but throwable fuse charges from above or below with ability to pairing them up seems reasonable for a start. Jackal, on the other hand, is very powerful. He denies roamers to roam. Roaming is a must on 9 out of 10 situations, and someone shutting that down is very similar as to Blackbeard having shield on his face. Not a single operator should be able to deny a fundamental thing, such as roaming. Adding to that, he has smoke grenade and a pocket shotgun, as well as both great primary weapons. What I would like to see is that, a longer time to scan footprints, and during the scan, defenders know that their footsteps are being scanned. Speaking of that, Caveira is no longer counter to Jackal. I will also take either Jackal shotgun or smoke grenade. Or Stu, you can put his eye scanner on the drone, and when droning he can see the footprints, but cannot scan them. He will way easier find where roamers are located with the Enox on the drone. Nomad, another powerful operator. She denies another fundamental thing of the game, which is flanking and jumping out of the windows to keep pressure on the attacker when needed. Nomad can make some window plays simply impossible to fight with, can make flanking non-existent and retake hard to think of. What I would like to see is a bigger range of an air jab, doubled or tripled, but it takes way more time to activate itself. Basically, the defender still should not be able to run through it, while it's not being thrown away, but the defender should also be possible to destroy it, or go for a player instead of destroying it, like, rather than destroying an air jab, then attack her. Amaru, and she's in the category of being underpowered, and it is simply because most of the time, her gadget is only okay in the starting round, to immediately get part of the map control if droned well, instead of wasting 10 to 15 seconds to get it. She has both good primary and secondary guns, and she brings a bit of uniqueness in the game. And with some pocket shots, she definitely can be good, but overall, I think she needs a bit of adjustment regarding her gadget. Maybe allow her to use immediately the grapple hook. I'm not sure what I will do to her and her gadget. Maverick, and he's definitely on the side of being overpowered because he has no actual counters. He also denies a very important aspect of the game, not fundamental thing, but still, which is bandit or Kai tricking, and he can also open huge wall or two hatches. What I would like to see is that he's being damaged when opening electrolyzed walls or hatches, and that he simply cannot open two reinforced hatches. That will be my starter point, him getting a counter and not allowing him to open hatches as fluently. Heavily balanced operators. Montaigne. Counters to him is playing 2 versus 1, and if you can throw a C4 behind him before not being picked off from Montaigne's teammate. I don't think that any operator should be countered only 1 versus 2, even if they cannot shoot. Montaigne can do loads of pressure even by just staring and unextending and extending his shield to defenders, as well as he can act as a light drone. In perfect world, I would delay the shields, but in siege world, I would make his shield malleable, to be as clashes. That still will not be enough. removing hip fire as we did on Blitz should also be done. Capitao is broken operator in squads, but Jekyll does roamers, Capitao does to anchors or to positions that are required to be covered as defenders close to the site, as Cat Falcon Clubhouse. He simply removes anchor spot, denies anyone trying to deny a planter, and on top of that, he has smoke grenades to deny the visual information. Thankfully, Vamai came to counter Capitao, but I don't think that it will be enough. I will remove that fire drops down from the ceiling, and I will make that smoke bolt last for around 5 seconds instead of 10. Dokkaebi, and definitely a broken operator, especially in squads. She can herself check if a floor is clear or not. You cannot bait as a defender her calls as you possibly could bait your teammate being tracked from the Jekyll. Sure, she doesn't have as good primary gun as Jekyll or other attackers do, but she has a broken gadget. First of all, I will make that if you want to keep their phones buzzing, that you have to stay still on that gadget. That way you're not a one-man army, but also your team cannot be drawn out from you. Will that be enough? I will not know. Maybe that she can hack only stationary cameras, not the ones that are being put during the preparation phase. And finally Lion, with a very similar reason to Dokkaebi, where you have to just stand still as a defender, and there is a good reason why Tachanka is bad. Sure, Lion may not seem as powerful in your rank gameplay, but if attackers know where you are, if they're about to activate EE1D, you're dead. You cannot move because Lions can, and they know you're exactly positioned due to drones or Jekyll. I will give him two special drones that cannot jump but can be attached on the ceiling, not cloaked, very similar to Yokai. And anyone nearby the drone moving around is detected, has to be visible on the drone. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any feedback, let me know down in the comment section below. If you would like to support me, drop me a like, subscribe and click the notification bell not to miss any video from my channel. Make sure to join my Discord server and to follow me on Twitter.